will be Detroit's 18th win in their last 26 games. And Goff has been at the heart of it, as has St. Brown. I mean, it is amazing. They begin last season 1-6. They finish with an 8-2 record. They pick up where they left off. They won at Arrowhead on the opening night against Kansas City. And now they're going to go to 10-4 with 3 games left.
And I mentioned it earlier in the game. I know the struggles that, you know, having lost 2 of 3. You have to remember those 2 losses were against division opponents that they had beaten earlier in the year. They're common opponents that know each other. That doesn't make an excuse for it. That just tells you that Green Bay and Chicago know everything there is to know about Detroit. Playing them twice a year and playing against Dan Campbell. And they just came out and focused in on the details.
Williams up the middle, met by Anzalone on that second down and 6, and he's up to the 33 with the first down. Gain of 8. As the clock will tick, Broncos are out of timeouts, and they're going to lose for just the second time in the last 8 weeks. Just the second loss in the last 8 games for Sean Payton, who did an incredible job to pull the team out of a 1-5 start, including a 50-point loss.
Well, and they've got 3 games to go. They'll be sitting at 7-7.
First and 10, P. Ryan. And he'll battle his way up near the 38-yard line. 9 touchdowns by LaPorta tonight as we just kind of wrap up, and all these things are falling into our lap fast. LaPorta with his 9 touchdown receptions, the most receiving touchdowns ever by a rookie in Lions history, by a tight end or by a wide receiver. 9 of them. And they've had some pretty good wide receivers here over the years.
Well, they definitely have. And really, you look at the direction this team is going, and Minnesota, at Minnesota next week, Vikings having a tough loss earlier in the day.
B. Ryan gets the first on 2nd and 5 on the pitch, and Martin will bring him down as he careens his way for 9.
But Minnesota's still at 7-7, and because of the NFC playoff picture, they're still right in the mix. So next week's game, you know, you've earned the right to play in these important games late in the season, and every one you win, the next one becomes that much more important. And what a great opportunity the Lions have put themselves in the rest of the way.
So the Lions are going to go to 10-4. They began 5-1 and 8-2. Did not turn it over. Their quarterback threw 5 touchdown passes tonight. Their rookie tight end caught 3. Their top receiver, St. Brown, had 112 receiving yards and a touchdown himself. And the Detroit Lions are rolling with the 3rd longest drop to the playoffs. They are so close now, and this is the way it looks. With Detroit leading, and they'll be watching that Monday night game up in Seattle. And if Seattle loses to Philadelphia, if the Eagles win, the Lions are in the playoffs for the first time since 2016.
Well, you can see how everybody's bunched up in that NFC. Minnesota at 7-7 right now would be the 2nd wild card team. So 2 of their next 3 games against the Vikings to try and secure the division, which it's been 30 years since the Lions have won the division.
Long time. Broncos are 7-7, losing their 2nd game in the last couple months. They had won 6 of 7 coming in, and you can see where they